Hello, dear colleagues. My name is Ghada Sayed Yusuf. I am an assistant professor of cardiology, Cairo University. Today, I'm going to talk to you about acute rheumatic fever. First of all, I would like to thank Professor Dr. Fathi Mokhladi, professor of cardiology, South Canal University, for the great help he provided me through preparation of this presentation. Acute rheumatic fever is an autoimmune disease in response to group AB, the hemolytic streptococcal infection of the throat. The body forms antibodies against the streptococcal antigens, and these antibodies cross-react with many body organs. Acute rheumatic fever is characterized by being a subtle disease, difficult to diagnose, and sometimes pass unnoticed. Acute rheumatic fever runs in families. It may affect more than one member of the same family. It usually affects the poor and the young individuals. The highest incidence is between school children between age 5 and 14, and in patients with living in crowded areas with poor healthcare service. That's why it's endemic in low and middle income countries, and the incidence is very low in North America and Europe. For diagnosis of acute rheumatic fever, we have Jones criteria. Jones criteria consists of major and minor features. The major features of Jones criteria are arthritis, which is the most commonly encountered disease of acute rheumatic fever or presentation of acute rheumatic fever. It's characterized by being migratory arthritis. It affects weight-bearing joints, big joints. It shows dramatic response to salicylates and usually leaves no residual effect. On the other hand, the carditis, which affects more than 50% of patients with acute rheumatic fever, it may cause damage to the heart valves and causes rheumatic heart disease. Sydenham's chorea affects about 10 to 30% of acute rheumatic fever patients, and it's characterized by being a latent presentation of acute rheumatic fever. It occurs about 3 months after throat infection with streptococci. The less common major criteria are subcutaneous nodules and erythema marginata. Jones criteria has first been described in 1944, and the manifestations or the major and the minor criteria have been changed through the years. Jones criteria has been evolved through the years and is modified and revised many times. The latest revision of Jones criteria occurs in 2015 by the American Heart Association. Where they classified individuals into individuals coming from areas with low risk of acute rheumatic fever and those coming from areas with high risk of acute rheumatic fever. They defined low risk of acute rheumatic fever by incidence less than 2 per 100,000 school-aged children per year, or an all-age prevalence of rheumatic heart disease of less than or equal 1 per 1,000 population per year. Otherwise, if the individual does not fit into this description, the individual is considered as high risk for acute rheumatic fever. The latest revised Jones criteria is described by the American Heart Association in 2015. For diagnosis of acute rheumatic fever, you need first an evidence of preceding group A streptococcal infection. Then you need to apply the Jones criteria. For the diagnosis of initial attack of acute rheumatic fever, you need either two major manifestations or one major plus two minor manifestations. And for diagnosis of recurrent acute rheumatic fever, you need either two major or one major and two minor, or even three minor criteria. Then they classify the population into low risk and the high risk populations. For the major criteria, low risk and the high risk populations were similar except for arthritis. Low-risk populations for diagnosis of arthritis, a major criteria, need a polyarthritis, while in high-risk populations, either polyarthritis or monoarthritis or even polyarthralgia are considered major criteria. For minor criteria, low-risk populations, minor criteria are polyarthralgia, fever more than 38.5, ESR more than 60, and prolonged PR interval, while in high-risk populations, monoarthralgia, fever more than 38, ESR more than 30, and prolonged PR are considered minor criteria. This is the most recent Australian guidelines for diagnosis and the prevention of acute rheumatic fever. It's quite similar to the American Heart Association guidelines, but they propose two other terms, the probable and possible acute rheumatic fever, where the clinical manifestation falls short of fulfilling Jones criteria. Probable acute rheumatic fever means it's highly suspected, while possible acute rheumatic fever means it is uncertain. The evidence of streptococcal infection is either elevated or rising streptococcal antibody titer, and the sensitivity of this test is about 80% in diagnosing acute rheumatic fever, a positive throat culture for group A beta hemolytic streptococci, and the sensitivity is only 40%, or a positive rapid group A strept carbohydrate antigen test in children whose clinical presentation suggests high probability of streptococcal pharyngitis. There are many anti-streptococcal antibodies that can be used for diagnosis of acute rheumatic fever. The most commonly used is anti-streptolysin O titer. There is also anti-deoxyribonuclease B, anti-streptokinase, anti-hyaluronidase, and anti-DNase. Combining anti-streptolysin O titer plus any of the other tests increases the sensitivity of the test for diagnosis of acute rheumatic fever to 90%. As regards the role of echocardiography in diagnosing acute rheumatic fever, the American Heart Association said that echocardiography should be performed in all cases of confirmed and suspected acute rheumatic fever. Echocardiography is class 1 indication to assess whether carditis is present in patients where the clinical findings are not present, especially in those patients coming from moderate to high risk populations when acute rheumatic fever is likely considered. And the absence of any abnormalities consistent with carditis in echocardiography should exclude the diagnosis of rheumatic carditis. It's class 2A indication to perform a serial echocardiography studies in any patient with diagnosed or suspected acute rheumatic fever. For management of acute rheumatic fever, you should manage the acute attack, you should manage the acute infection, and because acute rheumatic fever is a recurrent disease, you should prevent recurrence of acute rheumatic fever. We usually use salicylates to treat rheumatic arthritis. Steroids are used for management of acute fulminant carditis. Patients with carditis who develop heart failure need to be treated by conventional management of heart failure. And patient with permanent valvular lesion should be treated either by percutaneous or by surgical correction of these mechanical valvular lesions. For primary prevention of acute rheumatic fever, meaning prevention of rheumatic fever before it occurs, you should eradicate streptococcal throat infection. For secondary prevention of acute rheumatic fever, patient may use penicillin G, the dose of 1.2 million units intramuscularly every 4 weeks. And in individuals at high risk of developing acute rheumatic fever, the frequency should be every 3 weeks. For those who are intolerant to the intramuscular injections, they may use penicillin V at a dose of 200 mg twice daily. And for individuals who are allergic to penicillin, they may use sulfadiazine or macrolide antibiotics. The duration of secondary prophylaxis depends on the rheumatic lesions and the residual lesions. So patient with rheumatic fever with carditis and residual heart disease, they should receive prophylaxis until 10 years after the first attack or until their age is 40, whichever is longer. Those with rheumatic fever and the carditis but without residual heart disease, without meaning that without residual valvular lesions, they should receive prophylaxis for 10 years or until their age is 21, whichever is longer. And those with rheumatic fever without carditis should receive antibiotic prophylaxis until 5 years or until their age is 21, whichever is longer. And the Australian guidelines of acute rheumatic fever was quite similar to the American guidelines in describing penicillin G for secondary prophylaxis, and for individuals intolerant to intramuscular injections, they prescribe the penicillin V, and for those who are allergic to penicillin, they prescribe erythromycin 250 twice daily. Patients with acute rheumatic fever should be followed up after 3 to 4 months of the first attack and then yearly afterwards. Unless they have rheumatic heart disease, they should be followed up more frequently. The complications of acute rheumatic fever are the development of rheumatic heart disease and severe valvular lesions, the development of infective endocarditis, atrial fibrillation, and the development of heart failure. Acute rheumatic fever exerts high burden over the healthcare system. It is a highly recurrent disease with the highest recurrence occurs within 5 years of the first attack. With recurrent attacks of acute rheumatic carditis, patients develop rheumatic heart disease, and the incidence is 27% within 1 year. The incidence increases to 44% within 5 years, and within 10 years, more than half patients who had rheumatic carditis will develop rheumatic heart disease. More than 30% of patients with rheumatic heart disease will have severe rheumatic heart disease, means that they will require medications and intervention, whether percutaneous or surgical intervention. This model shows the burden of rheumatic heart disease, which is the commonest complication of acute rheumatic fever. It only starts with borderline echocardiographic findings, progresses to subclinical and clinical definite rheumatic heart disease, but still no symptoms. Once the patient starts to develop symptoms, now the disease is active and the progression is rapid. The mechanical lesion progresses to clinically definite cardiac failure. Rheumatic heart disease patients may develop complications. The valvular mechanical lesion may progress rapidly that it needs surgery, and with all the complications of prosthetic valves and the complications of anticoagulation, this seems to be the final destination. Thank you.